singer, a songwriter, and a radio personality. You can hear her on Songbird Radio Monday through Fridays from 3 to 6 p.m. on Monroe Country 104.9 FM WSKV. I am joined with Taylor Dye. She is with me.
Hi, Candy.
How's it going?
Hey, going good. How are you doing?
Doing real good. Thank you so much for joining me this evening. I truly appreciate it.
Yeah, no problem. I'm glad to be here.
And I want to let you know in advance that I know you have a show coming up 1 week from tonight at the Trista Cork, which is one of my favorite places to go. And I want to let you know that I will be there next Saturday.
Awesome. Yes, I love Trista Cork. Everyone there is awesome. If you haven't been there, you definitely need to come.
It is definitely a spot to be, not just for the music, but obviously for a lot of folks, the alcohol. Now, I'm not an alcohol drinker by any means. I don't drink alcohol, but, you know, for those who are or do drink responsibly, go there, check it out.
Such a fun atmosphere, too.
Yes, and shout out to Sue and the rest of the crew. She's such a darling, I will tell you that for sure.
I love Mama Sue.
Yes, yes, indeed. So, Taylor, what got you into becoming a musician? How did it all start it off for you?
Oh, gosh. Well, I guess as soon as I could talk, really, I started to sing. And in kindergarten, I started to take fiddle lessons. And it all just kind of went from there. I did lots of talent shows and performances, started picking up all kinds of instruments through my elementary school and high school. So I play probably 10-plus instruments. And, it just kind of came naturally. I played by ear. I could never even read music until I went to college. So, it just became somehow. No one in my family is really musical. So I don't really know. That's a hard question to answer.
Well, that's pretty cool. You play a lot of instruments. That definitely helps. I mean, some people start at a young age. Some people start late in their lives. But it was pretty much a given that, you know, I'm going to be a musician. And you're pretty good at it. So you have a good thing going. And I'm definitely am a fan of yours. And I first heard of you because you was part of a bill courtesy of the Trista Cork. Go back to that place again. Yeah. They have a show called Songwriter's Round, which is put together by Whitney Yakey. Our local singers are welcome to perform, and you can only perform original music. And you are on the same bill with her and another Taylor, as in Taylor Hughes. That is how I first heard of you. And I've heard your music on your YouTube page. And I played the latest cover you did, Burning House. I played that on the air.
Oh, yeah.
And I truly enjoy. I definitely enjoyed the cover of the song. I'm so used to hearing that song on my real job 5 days a week. But it's nice to hear it from for someone else once. So you did a good job with that cover.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate it. I used to post like a couple songs on YouTube a week. So if you want to follow my channel, all you have to do is type in my name. It's just Taylor Dye, D-Y-E. I know it's spelled weird, but it's D-Y-E.
Mm-hmm. So you
and can... I got lots of stuff on there.
So you can go to her YouTube page, subscribe, and, you know, she has some more songs to post. Now, you told me through Facebook that you have an album in the works.
Exciting. It's been in the works for a long time. You know, I've been writing music since I was, you know, in like 6th or 7th grade. And I have did little things here and there before, but I really wanted to do something, you know, professionally. And so this is what I'm doing. I'm going over and I'm recording with Ricky Walson over in Stanton. And I'm going to do an album of about 7 or 8 songs of completely original stuff. And I'm going to be in the studio next month, actually, next month in March. And hopefully it should be ready to go around mid-April or early May. That's going to be good for me because festival season actually starts up in around the end of April. So I'm going to be able to take my CD over to festivals that I do and other performances. So it's really exciting. I'm really happy to work with Ricky. He's really great. I've been in the studio a few times already, just checking things out. And yeah, it's just, I'm really excited to finally get something because people are always asking me, you know, where can I hear you? And I have to direct them to my YouTube. But now I'm going to be able to actually, you know, give them a copy of my original work, which is very, it's awesome for me.
Well, congratulations on the pursuit of making this album happen. I'm definitely looking forward to buying a copy of your CD for sure. Do you know what the name of the album's going to be? Have you come up with a title for the album yet?
You know what? I have not. I'm actually still working on 2 of the songs, if that tells you anything. It'll probably come to me, you know, after it's all said and done, you know, after I kind of feel out how it's going to go together, and maybe I can draw some inspiration then.
Okay, that's cool. So as of right now, it's untitled. But Taylor, we'll mm-hmm. keep you guys and girls posted. Taylor Dye, D-Y-E, music.com is the website. All of her social media links are on there, so you can keep in track with her. And most definitely, she's got her list of upcoming shows. As I've already mentioned, this coming Wednesday, Taylor will be at Austin City Saloon this coming Wednesday. And then a week from tonight, she's going to be at the Twisted Cork. So show your support. Support local music. Now, you are from Georgetown, I believe. You obviously perform in Lexington and other areas in Kentucky, but have you performed in your neck of the woods in Georgetown?
Well, actually, I just went to school in Georgetown. I know all my stuff, it says I live in Georgetown, but I just haven't updated it yet. I actually live in Boonville, Kentucky, which is southeast Kentucky. It's in Owsley County.
Oh, okay.
And I perform pretty much everywhere in eastern and central Kentucky. And, you know, I hit up all the festivals around here. And I haven't actually performed in Georgetown other than on the campus at our chapel, our John O. Hill Chapel there. But I would look forward to playing in Georgetown at any chance I get.
Okay, that's cool. Thank you for the clarification. So as far as music is concerned, who do you consider as your influences in music?
Well, that's always a hard one, but usually what I tell people is really like, I like some oldies, just to be honest, like Loretta Lynn, Hank Jr., AC/DC, really enjoy Chris Stapleton. Anything he does is obviously amazing, and he's killing it right now. It's crazy because 2 years ago, I was at the same festival with him, and there was literally no one there. I mean, me and a few others were the only ones who had even heard of him before, and that was over in London, Kentucky. But now he's blown up, and I just love everything he does, always have. And, yeah, I just try to draw inspiration from across the board. I love Miranda Lambert. Matchbox 20, I like people from rock to bluegrass to folk. I listen to a lot of different stuff. So I try to pick from each different genre things that I like about people and try to make it, you know, unique to me.
Well, it's interesting that you brought up with Chris Stapleton because, as you point out, he's on quite a roll these days. He won a Grammy about a couple of weeks ago.
Yes.
I mean, he's doing big things. He's come a long way. He's very successful. And, you know, I've lived in Kentucky for most of my life. So any chance we get to see someone in Kentucky shine the way that he has, definitely a great thing. I'm definitely looking forward to hear what Jordan Smith got cooking now that he's won The Voice and everything. And, of course, the new season of The Voice coming up. It was great to see him win. Very talented singer as well. So, obviously, I go to local shows. I see people do covers from time to time. What are some of your favorite songs of covers that you like to do when you're out there performing?
Oh, that's a good one. I do a lot of Miranda Lambert stuff. I really like all her songs. I just do a lot of different stuff. I do Drift Away. I do Drops of Jupiter. I do Walking After Midnight by Patsy Cline. Do some Bob Seger, Night Moves. Just really a variety. I do Girl Crush by Little Big Town. Even do some Steve Miller Band. Just I'm everywhere at a show. I did some Adele last week at Twisted Cork, and everybody really liked that. So really, it's untelling what you're going to get with me when I get on stage. Just whatever I'm feeling, you know, I just kind of play off how I'm feeling that day.
Well, that's the type of artist I like, you know, the unpredictability in sorts. So I'm definitely going to enjoy your
I have my favorites that I like to come back to, but at the same time, I like to kind of, you know, look at the crowd, see what they're digging at the moment, see what they're really liking, and then I kind of play off them, and just that's how I like to do it. I like to get the crowd involved. I've been known to bring people up on stage with me to sing, and that's just how I like to do it.
Oh, okay. Well, that's something I never heard a local artist would do. Just bring a volunteer, let them sing.
It was funny because, I guess it was 2 times ago at the Twisted Cork service, and when they wanted to hear some John Prine, and I wanted to do In Spite of Ourselves, and I didn't have anyone to sing it with me, so I brought one of the women up on stage, and she sang it with me, and they had such a great time from that, and, you know, they were taking pictures and posting it, so it's good for me, and it's good for them, so it's a lot of fun.
Indeed, it is a lot of fun. Now, I want to talk about this radio gig you got going on. You are the hostess of Songbird Radio Monday through Friday from 3 to 6. It's at 104.9 FM WSKV. What made you decide to become a radio personality? Did they reach out to you? You reach out to them? How did that get started for you?
Well, that's kind of a funny story, actually. I went to college at Georgetown College, and I loved it there. And I studied a classical voice and vocal performance and business. And I knew I wanted to perform. That's pretty much what I wanted to do. So I graduated back in May, and I just started doing a lot of performances, a lot of festivals, a lot of gigs, parties, just everything I could get my hands on. And the manager over at WSKV ran the sound for a lot of my gigs this summer in Eastern Kentucky. And they had hired the radio station to come and do the sound. So he saw me perform a couple times. And then they approached me and said, hey, we have this job, and we think you would be great on our team. And that's pretty much how it unfolded. I had no intentions of getting into radio, but I absolutely love it. I'm so glad that it happened the way it did. And I never really thought I'd be doing something like that, but here I am.
A blessing in disguise is what I like to call it. And
absolutely.
So it's worked out for you. I have not heard your show as of yet, but I definitely will be sure to do that most likely on Fridays, because by the time you off the air, I'm off from work. So maybe I should, you know, reach out to my quote-unquote supervisor, said maybe you need to put this particular station on at a certain time frame, you know what I mean, but you know, I guess it doesn't hurt but to try, I suppose. Now, I've already mentioned Arthur C. Salom and Twisted Cork. What are some of the other shows that you are looking forward to in the coming weeks and months?
Well, I'm actually already scheduled for a few festivals. I'm not sure if I have them on my schedule list on my website yet. But I do sing in a lot of churches as well. This week, the next weekend coming up, I'm singing at a church in Boonville. And then the first non-Twisted Cork thing I have is in downtown Richmond. They have a farmer's market. And I'll be doing that for 2 weekends. I'll be doing the NADA Festival over in NADA, Kentucky, Community Days over in Salyersville, and Hillbilly Days over in Pikeville. And that's what I have scheduled so far. But there will definitely be more to come.
Basically, you all over, like you said, you all over Kentucky pretty much.
Yeah, and I know I perform at the Black Gold every year, the Chicken Festival every year, that's in Hazard in London, the Sorghum Festival over in West Liberty, and of course a lot of these places haven't started doing their entertainment schedule yet, which is why I haven't booked with them, but they've already gave me confirmation that I will be coming back this year, so don't have dates for you yet, but I will on my TaylorDynamusic.com page.
So for the complete list of dates that you have coming up, people can go to your official website at TaylorDyeMusic.com. That's D-Y-E music.com. You can check out her social media links. They're all posted there as well. And, well, Taylor, if you can have a dream collaboration, it could be with any artist of any genre, dead or alive. What would that dream collaboration be?
Okay, let's see. I'm going to have a three-way tie because okay. I'm a cheater.
It's okay.
It's all right. I'm going to say Garth Brooks, number one. Number two, Billy Joel. Number three, Chris Stapleton.
Definitely got to put the Kentuckian in there somehow, you know, so.
Yeah. I think he's amazing. He's never put out anything bad. I just think that would be interesting to do something with him.
I will say that performance he did with Justin Timberlake at the Country Music Awards last year definitely was sensational. It was sensational.
Yeah, I was basically in tears the whole time because I just couldn't believe it. It was so good.
Yes, so well, Taylor, it was great chatting with you. Thank you so much for your time. I'm definitely looking forward to seeing more of you in the future, including next Saturday night at the Twisted Cork. Make sure you all come through. The show starts at 8 o'clock, I believe. So that means I will be there for the second hour because I'm on from 8 to 9 p.m. Eastern. But I will be headed that way. After chilling, it's off the air. And look forward to finally getting a chance to meet you. And you doing good things, not just as a musician, but as a radio personality, which gives you the platform to get the word out on other artists. And I salute you on that. Thank you so much for your time. Continued success. I'm looking forward to your debut album coming soon. And thank you for your time, Taylor. I truly appreciate it.
Well, I do thank you for letting me come on the show, and I can't wait to meet you on Saturday.
All right, you have a good night, and have a great weekend.
You too. Bye.
All right, bye-bye. That was Taylor Dye joining me on Chilling with Jeffrey Kenny C.